Now, I've spoken about Auracast so much in my YouTube videos over the last couple of years that when I heard the transmitters were finally in production, I could not wait to get my hands on them and have one installed in the clinic, which I've heard is an incredibly simple thing to do. But I'll save that for another video in the future. Much to the dismay of everybody in my practice, we haven't installed it yet because I've grabbed it to make today's video and show you exactly what it consists of. For those of you that like some of the technical detail, this is the Auri TX2N transmitter, which is a professional grade, low profile device designed for seamless integration into various environments. It uses a plug and play approach with no complicated wiring necessary, and for very little expense. As I've mentioned, one of the key benefits is it can be installed anywhere and users don't need to pair to be able to receive a transmission from it. In fact, it's so powerful that the Auracast broadcasted audio can connect an unlimited number of compatible receivers without the need for pairing. As I brushed over earlier, it has a range of 100 meters with a clear line of sight, and therefore there is no question that it will replace all assistive technology going forwards. The single transmitter is equipped with two Bluetooth 5.3 radios, allowing for flexible routing options and the capability to broadcast separate audio streams simultaneously. Plus, you have the ability to choose between analog mic, line inputs, or Dante inputs, with individually switchable 24 volt phantom power supporting mono, stereo, or dual mono configurations. It's also worth me mentioning that as ReSound are ahead of the curve, they also have personal Auracast transmitters such as their TV streamer, allowing for the same features but just on an at-home level. Moving on to the RX1 receivers, which are designed to receive high quality, low latency audio from the Auri transmitter for those without Auracast compatible hearing aids. Again, for those of you that love detail, you'll be delighted to hear that they use Bluetooth 5.3 for receiving real-time audio broadcasts from Auri transmitters, supporting both mono and stereo formats, and do so at a low latency between 29 to 45 milliseconds, depending on the sample rate and configuration, meaning that you shouldn't experience synchronization issues between your ears and your eyes. You'll notice here that the RX1 is equipped with two 3.5mm TRRS jacks compatible with standard headphones and inductive neck loop. So, building on what I was saying earlier, they can cater for those of you wearing non-Auracast ready hearing aids with a built-in telecoil. From a practical standpoint, it features a rechargeable lithium polymer battery offering over 20 hours of continual use, with a full recharge taking just 4 hours. And then from a usability point of view, you can see the OLED display showing channel information, battery status, signal strength, and volume levels. And in my opinion, it's the small things that make all the difference, with the display brightness adjusting itself based on ambient light. As far as controls go, in my opinion, they couldn't be more intuitive, allowing for control over the power, volume up and down, and two multifunction soft buttons for easy operation. And then finally, as far as the charging goes, you'll have the option for either using a USB-C cable or via their dedicated docking stations. So if you want the full lowdown on which hearing aids are Auracast ready, you must check out this video covering the best hearing aids of 2025.